All right, day 10 is done. So today I decided, I think about yesterday, and decided to pull the trigger on it today, obviously because I'm done also. Instead of doing a marathon, instead of doing 26.2 miles, I wanted to do a 50K today to end it. And so that's what I did. I went out to Woodward Park, and after I dropped my kids off at school, I figured I had about 6 hours. So dropped them off at 8. Stopped off at Fit 36 really quick to do something with one of the trainers. Then was on the trail at the park about 8:30, and figured I could be out there till 2:30, taking 6 hours. I feel it's plenty of time to sneak in 31 miles. All I had to do was maintain a little bit faster than a 12-minute mile. Just a little bit faster than 5 miles an hour, and I knew that I could kind of briskly jog that with a little bit of walking here and there, because there's a few hills that, I mean, they're not crazy, but after you do go around it, I don't even know how many times it is, it's like a 2.65 or 2.7 mile loop, you know, divided by, that's funny, sorry, text message, divided by 31. I'm not even going to try to do the math right now, but it's quite a few times, right? So all those little hills that I normally run end up, for me, feeling kind of large towards the end. So I just walk those from the very beginning and just kind of save my legs. But I think I finished like 5 hours and like 40 minutes or somewhere around there. I can't remember altogether at the top of my head what it was, but pretty good run. I felt great. Day 9 of this was the only day that I really kind of felt like my legs were, not so much my legs, my feet were tired, man. Like, I remember just, we were on the track, and had a ton of people out there with me, which was great. And I just remember telling, like, Alicia was like, man, my feet are killing me. I just want to get done. And, I remember when I was done, and everyone had to take off, and my buddy Chris, him and I just, like, sat there for a while, and I just didn't even watch the car. But today felt really great. I was very thankful about how good I felt. Other than that, like, it was a great run. My friend Benny Madrigal came out. I've known Benny for a long time, just through, like, running. Super cool guy, really fast marathoner. Just really, really talented runner, cyclist. He's done, I know one Ironman, I don't know how many he's done. He's a type 1 diabetic. He's actually on a team of all, everyone on this team that he's part of has type 1 diabetes, and they go around and they like kind of tour around, and they do races, and they give talks on like how to deal with diabetes and as an athlete, and he's just a really cool guy. So he came out, he got a hold of me yesterday. Let me know, hey, you know, I want to come out and run with you a little bit. I've been wanting to all week. Finally fit in the schedule. Luckily on the last day. So, while I was running, had my phone on me. He called me while I was out there. Figured out where to meet on the loop. And he ran for 2 hours with me, which was awesome. That was the first time I've ever ran with Benny, because he's really fast. So, I normally want to run with him, because there's no way I'm going to keep up with him. And, we talked for 2 hours and just kind of like, you know, got to know each other a little bit more. You know, usually when I see him, it's just at Fleet Feet for like, you know, 20 minutes maybe. And it's not like a long, engaging conversation. You know, we talk about shoes and about running and just whatever we have coming up. But it was kind of cool just getting to know him a little bit and talk to him. Talk to him a little bit about Tibet. And he wanted to know why I was, running 10 days in a row. And it was cool being able to tell him why and, you know, how I got my first kind of dealing with everything, going to the Free Tibet concert in San Francisco back in, I think it was like 97, because my friends and I had no idea what Tibet was, but we knew that there's a lot of cool bands playing that we liked. We saw, you know, Beastie Boys, Smashing Pumpkins, Tribe Called Quest, Q-Tip was there. Just the whole bunch of people. It was a 2-day event, and then during that show is where they had some of the monks come out and talk about just all their stories about what's going on in Tibet with the Chinese occupation and torture that's going on, and just these really powerful stories that, you know, we went there just thinking it was going to be like a cool 2-day concert, which it was, and you know, walked away with a little bit of information about something I had no idea of that was going on in the world, and didn't really get too involved with it at the time. And then very long, quick story short, going through some stuff in life, started reading about Buddhism. I by no means would consider myself a Buddhist, but I love the philosophy, and I've, you know, read a lot of books, we'll say, and have a pretty good collection of books that I've read. But yeah, it's I think what's going on over there is, I don't know, it's very tragic. It's just a group of people who wanna, you know, have their country and practice their religion, and you know, they're not able to. We take so many things for granted in this country, and you know, it's just wild to know that, like, you could, if a Tibetan is caught with the Tibetan flag, they're thrown in jail. That's crazy, you know. If they have a picture of the Dalai Lama, they'll get tortured and beat and thrown in prison. That's what's going on. That's why I ran 10 days in a row. And all I did was run. It was really no big deal. You know, I had a few people tell me, like, oh, what you're doing is, you know... It's funny to me when people throw, like, amazing. Oh, it's amazing what you're doing. I'm just running, you know. I'm not doing anything amazing. I'm using something that I'm able to do to hopefully bring awareness to a topic that needs more attention. That's all I'm doing. I'm not doing anything great. I personally don't feel like I'm doing anything that someone else who's in my position wouldn't do. It's just the way that I can use something that I'm decent at and hopefully get some people's attention. Hopefully there's a few people who I didn't know who heard maybe from a friend, hey, I know this guy that's running really far, like 10 days in a row. Maybe they, you know, maybe that sparked some kind of interest, like, well, why? Why would you do that? And that was the goal. Fundraising the money was great. We fundraised over $1,000, which was the goal. I guess I should have made it 2, because I think we probably could have hit that. So next year, I'll have to plan a little bit bigger, I guess. But the whole goal of this was just to kind of spread some awareness, try to raise some money to a cause that I think is very well deserving. There's plenty of causes out there, you know. I think it's good to pick one that you stand behind and, you know, try to make a difference. I think at the end of the day, you know, try to do a little bit more good than bad. I know I've done my share of bad stuff, you know, just in general. Or, you know, stuff that hindsight, you know, could have done a different way. But I think at the end of the day, if you're trying to leave a good mark in the world, that's what's important. That's, I think, what I was kind of trying to do the last 10 days. Yeah, I feel like I'm kind of going off on a tangent here. Kind of went all the way off from the run, but whatever. But yeah, I'll probably plan something else again. You know, originally I wanted to run from Fresno to Washington, D.C. That just, unfortunately, did not work out. And, you know, super bummed about that still. But at least with this, I figured out what my body could handle. I could handle a marathon for 10 days. If I run from here to D.C., man, I'm going to have to do like 50 miles a day. I think I actually figured out that I would want to do 60. And it's going to be a lot more than 10 days. Yeah, so I think this is a good start. I will eventually run to D.C. I know that as a fact. Even, you know, if I have to wait till I retire, I'll do it. You know, that's going to eventually happen. I might ride my bike first. I think that would be a good idea because I could actually check out the route. And while I was talking to Benny today during our run, there's actually one of his teammates that ran from San Francisco to is either D.C. or New York. So we were kind of talking about that, and he said, well, I could find out the route, a good route to take. So who knows? I mean, you never know what the next day is going to bring. I don't know. But thanks for watching all the videos, and just kind of, you know, everyone who helped out, everyone who donated money, everyone who came out and ran, everyone who just checked on me every day. You know, my parents couldn't have done this without them, all their love and support. With, you know, since I started running and doing ultras, they've been at just about, I think they haven't been at 200 milers that I've ran out of like the 21 or 22. They just haven't been to San Diego because it was too far. Didn't want to bother them with that. But yeah, I mean, if I ever asked them to be somewhere, they're there. They offered to help any way that they could over the last 10 days. And luckily, you know, I was in town and didn't need too much help. My parents are great when it comes to backing me on stuff. They might not agree with what I'm doing, they might not get it, but they're always there. Also couldn't have done this without, I had Alicia every day texting me during the run. You know, we talked every day. Well, we always talk every day, but but just about how I was doing mentally and physically with it. She came out and ran a lot with me. Sunny, you know, she kind of helped me with the idea. We didn't quite pull off what we were intending to. I was supposed to get a sponsor for every day, and just time kind of went by too quick, and I didn't get it. I didn't pull it off as big as I wanted to, but I raised all the money I wanted to, so that's good enough. And got a lot of people, I think I got some curiosity with some people who didn't know. I had a lot of people ask me, well, what's Tibet? And I was like, well, we talked for a while. I was like, hey, you know, you should be on Google, look it up, you know, see what's going on. Form your own opinion and, you know, see what you think. And, Sunny played a pretty big role in kind of figuring out what I wanted to do. We talked a lot during some of our trail runs. I don't know if she even remembers, but I kind of bounced some ideas off her. When my ideas were getting a little bit too far out, she would kind of reel it in for me. And she's always that friend, you know, have some kind of crazy idea, something I want to do, and you know, she has a great way of kind of bringing it back to earth when it's all the way out there, and giving me her opinion as to what maybe I can do instead that's more feasible. And then my friend Megan, you know, always cool to talk to. She ran one day with me, just texted me all the time, seeing how I was doing. Would like to run with her more, but hey, that's life, you know. Work and everything gets in the way. I just have a lot of cool people supporting me, and I think that Alicia, Sunny, and Megan definitely made this adventure easier. Not that it was easy, but they made it more doable for me. Because I know that if I needed anything, I could just call one of the three of them up, and they'd be there, you know. So, other than that, what's next? I have no idea, but there'll be something.